Yo, chefs, this guide is about frying in a pan, or more simply known as pan frying. Pan frying falls in between saute and deep frying, where saute uses a small amount of oil and then deep frying uses a large amount of oil. Pan fry only needs just enough oil to cover about 1/4 to 1/2 of the chicken. And that usually will require you to flip it at least once. You can drench the chicken in flour to create a crispier product. Alternatively, you can bread it to create a thicker, even more crispy product. The object of breading is to create a seal encasing the chicken, which prevents oil from getting in and making the chicken greasy. So this fosters a crispy outside and then a nice tender, juicy inside. Now the breading station, known professionally as the standard breading procedure, is set up something like this. You have flour, egg wash, and breadcrumbs. And then you've got a place to put the chicken after it's gone through the breading procedure. I know it seems excessive, but trust and believe every ingredient has a purpose. Like the flour adheres to the chicken and then to the egg, and then the breading adheres to the egg, which creates that seal that you need to create a crispy outside and a juicy inside. Now, of course, you want to season your chicken before you go through the breading process, and the easiest way to do that is to season your flour. So you can season it with spices, herbs, salt, pepper, whatever you want. You just want to put it into the flour and then go through the breading process. Now for the egg, what we want to do is create an egg wash, and that's just egg mixed with liquid, which is usually either milk or water. And the ratio that you're looking for is going to be 1 tablespoon of liquid to 1 whole egg. And then you just whisk that up until it's well blended, and then you're good to go. Now for the breading, you don't have to use breadcrumbs. You can use other things, like you can just use flour. You can use things like cereal, crackers, chips, popcorn, even dried fruit would work too. Now for the breading process, you could use tongs, but you could also use the wet hand, dry hand technique. And how that works is the wet hand is only going to deal with the wet ingredients, while the dry hand is only dealing with the dry ingredients. And what that does is that helps prevent your fingers from getting caked up if you just did the whole process with one hand. So, I have my wet hand and my dry hands, I'm all ready. So first we're going to take the chicken and put it into the flour. And you wanna dredge this in the flour, and just make sure that everything is coated. And then what you wanna do is shake off all the excess. And then you lay it into the egg like that. And then with your wet hand, you take that and you flip it. And just make sure that it's completely covered in the egg wash. And then you take that and let the excess drip off of that. And then you put it into your breadcrumbs. And then with your dry hand again, just get that coated with the breadcrumbs. And what I'm doing is I'm just patting it down just to make sure that the coating is sticking to the egg. All right, and then you shake off any excess there, and then put it in your breading zone. Okay, now I have another one over here that I'm gonna go ahead and get breaded real quick, and then we're gonna get to frying. So I have my pan set up with the oil and it's coming up to temperature. And you'll know when the oil is done because it'll start to swim, meaning it'll take on the properties of water. So it'll kind of look and flow like water and less like oil. Okay, so mine is up to temperature and I'm ready to go ahead and fry the chicken. And so what you want to do is you just want to be really, really careful. And you're going to want to just kind of take it and just kind of lay it in. You don't want to like drop it in. That's not anything. Okay, so just lay it in just like this. So we're gonna let that cook on that side until it's golden brown, and then we're gonna go ahead and flip it and let that side cook until it's golden brown, and then you're ready to go. There you have it, pan-fried chicken, another method for your repertoire. Good for rice, pasta, salads, and sandwiches. And you know I have to try this out. Chick-fil-A, I got nothing on this. That is deliciousness on a plate. For joining me in my kitchen, thank you bunches. Yo, let me know in the comments if you would try this method and what sides you'd make with it. Hit the like button if you like this guide and subscribe for more guides and recipes. I hope you've learned from this visual guide to chicken breast brought to you by my e-guide, A College Guide to Chicken Breast, available for free download on my website.